Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can calculate factorial of a number using pointer. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechImage, which is available on Google Play. Now I am going to implement a code in front of you, which will demonstrate you how you can calculate factorial of a number using pointer. So I am defining main function. Inside main function, I am declaring a variable n which will receive a number from user, then a pointer p, then f which is initialized with 1, and then variable I. Now first I am using printf statement, which will display the message enter a number on console. The entered number will be received by scanf, and that number will be stored inside n variable. Now for calculation purpose, I have declared a variable f which is initialized with 1, but now I am assigning address of f into p. So for calculation purpose, instead of f, I will be using p pointer, because p is containing address of f, and whenever I will be modifying values through p, then that effect will be made upon f variable automatically. So for that purpose, I am using a loop which will repeat n times, and inside this loop I am going to apply the statement, that is asterisk p equals to asterisk p into I, and I can enclose this asterisk p into parenthesis. So this way you can see, without pointer we have to write f equals to f into I. So if I am not using pointer, then I have to write f equals to f into I. Now instead of f, I am using asterisk p. So p is containing address of f. So if I am modifying a value of if I want to modify value of f through pointer, then I can write asterisk p equals to asterisk p into I. So asterisk p will be providing value of f, then it will be multiplied with I, and then the result will be stored again asterisk into asterisk p. So p is pointing to f, so the updated value will be automatically stored inside f variable. Now after completion of this calculation, I can print the calculated factorial of on console using this printf statement, and with the help of f. So here you can see, at the time of calculation I have not used f directly, but I have used a pointer p which is pointing to the address of f. So pointer has modified the value of f, that's why I am able to print the calculated result with the help of f variable. Now I am using return 0. Now I am going to execute this code. I am entering 5 as a number. You can see the result, factorial equals to 120. So the output is correct. So program is working properly. This way I have calculated factorial with the help of pointer. I have not directly used the variable which is responsible for printing the factorial result, but instead of that variable I have used its pointer. So whenever pointer points to a location through its address, then through that pointer we can receive that value which is available into a variable, and we can also modify value of that variable with the help of pointer. So through p I have managed both the requirements. I have accessed value of f through p, and I have modified value of f through p pointer. So that's why this output is displayed on console correctly. I hope you have understood how we can use a pointer for any calculation instead of variables. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechMS, which is available on Google Play. Thank you for watching this video.